There is an equilibrium is already there after combustion and beyond equilibrium. The primary burn mixture charts are for the products of combustion at high temperature. That is for the working fluid during the expansion process. The following assumptions are made while devising these charts. These are basically, charts are basically a source of data. Like we had steam tables in the form of tabular form of data. Then we had Mollier charts, a chart based a graphical source of data. Chart is a graphical source of data on x axis and y axis. Two axes are there, 2x based data. Then Mollier, then steam tables being simply a table based data. Similarly here in IC engines, we have used a tabular data NUR last time. And we have used the chart based data also for solving the numerical for the compression process. And today we'll be doing same thing for the expansion process after combustion. Just like steam tables and Mollier charts, you could be discussing steam turbines, you could be discussing nozzles or entire steam power plants, and used to you are in need of data for solving the numerical. You know, what is the work done by the turbine, then a corresponding changes in the thermodynamic properties, which cannot be solved without the data. This data, you know, this data is basically a corresponding to the thermodynamic state during compression. If the compression process, as discussed yesterday, was from state number one to state number two, the corresponding thermodynamic properties at stage number one and stage number two should be minimum properties as per the thermodynamic postulate. You know, how many properties will define the thermodynamic state incomplete, you know, as a complete. Minimum number of thermodynamic properties required to describe the state of a system. If you revise your basic thermodynamics, the state postulate tells you how many thermodynamic properties minimum are required to describe the state of a system. Similarly, you know, these properties are same, but we have to locate the numerical value of these properties. We have to find out the numerical value of these properties in the combustion charts or unburned mixture charts. Our thermodynamic charts, unburnt and burnt, these mixture charts. I should not use the word combustion. You know, they are basically unburnt mixture and burnt mixture. The combustion is not. You know, the combustion. If somehow I wrongly spell the combustion, it is not there. It's mixture chart basically before combustion and after combustion. Before combustion means combustion process, and after combustion means during expansion process. Because these thermodynamic properties, you know, they help us to, you know, to describe the state of a system. Number two, to calculate something else like work done on the system, work done by the system, by using corresponding laws of thermodynamics. Just as we have used the first law of thermodynamics for a process yesterday only. Then, you know, while trying to generate data, you know, for some use as an approximate basis for solving the numericals, the data will help you in solving the practical problems. You know, if it is not known exactly, the data is not known exact in an exact, you know, with an exact value, you know, then with the help of some assumptions, the data may be generated and that data is available to give the approximate solution of the problems. The following assumptions are made. Each species in the mixture can be modeled as an ideal gas. You know, we have first ideal gas. Then we have ideal gas laws. Then we have, mixtures of ideal gases and corresponding thermodynamic, you know, relationships getting involved. The mixture is in the thermodynamic equilibrium at temperatures above 1700 degree Kelvin. The mixture composition is frozen below 1700 degree Kelvin. Datum at the datum state of 298.15 Kelvin, 25 degrees Celsius, and one atmosphere, the chemical elements in their naturally occurring form, nitrogen, oxygen, hydrogen, as diatomic gases and carbon as solid graphite, are assigned zero enthalpy and entropy. You know, these gases, these species, these species in the burn gas, like nitrogen, oxygen, hydrogen, and carbon, you know, all species in the combustion products, they are assigned zero enthalpy and entropy, corresponding to the temperature of 298.15 Kelvin and one atmosphere. You know, the minimum number of properties to describe the state of the system, 298.15 Kelvin and one atmosphere, if there is some deficiency, then other properties should also be included. You know, then only we can have that data in a tabular form or a graphical form. Then carbon to hydrogen and oxygen to nitrogen ratio of the mixture is specified for each charge. You know, basically we have a charge for isooctane. Then we have so many number of charts given in the book by John B. Haywood. These are basically for isooctane. Then which corresponds to the fuel known as petrol. Then we have for different equivalence ratio, say 0.2, 0.4, 0.6, 0.8, 1.0, and 1.2. Once we know the definition of fuel air equivalence ratio, then we should be able to calculate the corresponding air fuel ratio as well, once we know the stoichiometric fuel air ratio. The extensive properties, internal energy, enthalpy, entropy, and specific volume are all expressed per unit mass of air in the original mixture. These are the assumptions, you know, when the data was tabulated in a tabular form or when the data was compiled in a graphical form. These are the assumptions while trying to generate data. You know, they correspond to the combustion of 1 kg of air with the appropriate mass of fuel. The mass basis for the unburned and burned mixture charts are the same. Then this figure 5 to 9, this is as per the book by John B. Haywood. You know, they are basically property charts for the high temperature burn gas. Each is the plot of internal energy versus entropy for a particular fuel and equivalence ratio. Basically, the fuel there is isooctane, and so many charts from 5 to 9 with the corresponding equivalence ratio of 0.2, 0.4, 0.6, and 0.8, 1.0, and 1.2. All charts are with respect to two axes. On y axis, we have internal energy. On the x axis, we have entropy. Then on the same chart, we have lines of constant temperature, constant pressure, and constant specific volume are drawn on each chart, you know, so that if you are if you are able to locate the state of a system by some maybe state number one at a particular point on the chart, then we could be able to find out the corresponding values of temperature, pressure, and specific volume. And also while trying to go towards the y-axis, we should be able to find out the value of internal energy. And while trying to go towards x-axis, we are able to find out the corresponding value of entropy. After locating the point on the chart and going towards x-axis vertically downwards, we get entropy. Going horizontally leftwards towards y-axis, we get internal energy. Then, you know, trying to get the values of temperature, pressure, and specific volume from the constant lines that pass through that point. Then we have the example. The expansion process in an internal combustion engine. This expansion process here, you know, if you have a look at the graph here, this is the expansion process PV diagram. Expansion means from state number one to state number two, this is expansion. Expansion means when there is, you know, an increase in the volume and there is a drop in the pressure. The expansion process in an internal combustion engine following completion of combustion can be modeled approximately as an adiabatic and reversible process. You know, ideal process, isentropic. Under full load operation, the pressure in the cylinder of a SI engine at top center immediately following combustion is 7100 kilopascals. Find the gas state at the end of expansion stroke and the expansion stroke work. That means gas state means you find out the corresponding thermodynamic properties after expansion, and also calculate numerically the expansion stroke work. The compression ratio of the engine or the process is 8, and the mixture is stoichiometric, that means phi is equal to 1.0, and the volume per unit mass of air at the start of expansion is 0.12 cubic meter per kg of air. Then, you know, since what is given there, you know, we have P1 given as 7100 kilopascal, that is given, then V1 is given as 0.125 cubic meters per kg of air. You know, the total, you know, total, the volume per unit mass of air at the start of expansion is 0.125 cubic meters per kg of air. Corresponding use of 1 kg of air with the corresponding amount of corresponding mass of the fuel. Then phi is 1. With these three values, you know, the value of phi, the value of phi helps us to select the chart, because charts are basically for iso-octane only, and charts are for different values of phi. After knowing the value of phi as 1.0, we go to the same chart, that is figure 8. Then we have two points P1 and V1, and we want to locate this point corresponding to P1 and V1. And once we locate point number one corresponding to P1 and V1, let us see how. Now we are here, the P1 was given at 7100 something, 70, these are constant pressure lines. If we can, magnify it, somebody, let us see, let him come. Now we have a constant pressure lines here. 200, the corresponding units are given. For the pressure, you have kilonewtons per meter square. Then for volume, cubic meters per kg of air, temperature in Kelvin. Then fuel is iso-octane here. Then equivalence ratio is 1. After doing equivalence ratio, we have chosen this chart. There are many more charts for different equivalence ratio. Then on the y-axis, it is internal energy U with the corresponding units kilojoules per kg of air. And on the x-axis, we have entropy S with the units kilojoules per kg of air Kelvin. Then on this chart, we have lines of constant temperature, say 3600 degree, 3600 Kelvin, 3400 Kelvin, 3200 Kelvin, 3000 Kelvin, 2800 Kelvin, 2600 Kelvin, and likewise, you go to right hand side, you can see the corresponding lines. Say for example, 1800 Kelvin line is here. Then we have lines of constant pressure, say 20,000 kilonewton per meter square. Then we have 13,000, then we have 6,500, then we have 4,000, then we have 2,200. Likewise, we have the volume, that will be the corresponding cubic meters corresponding to 1 kg of air, say 0.38, 0.20, 0.10, 0.04. So lines of constant specific volume, lines of constant pressure, and lines of constant temperature are there on the chart, So in the numerical, two things were given, P1 and V1, P1 and V1, that is somewhere here, 7100 kilopascals was given perhaps, if I remember. This is 6500, then there is 13,000. Between 6500 and 13,000, we have the constant pressure line that goes like this, 7100 kilopascal, a kilopascal, this is convertible to kilopascal, so it will be here. Then, then you have V1 also. You can see the corresponding value of V1. That means we are able to locate this point. Once we locate this point with two values, with any two values like P1 and V1, we should be able to locate the point after carefully, magnifying the graph and trying to locate the point more accurately, at least for the sake of understanding it and at least for the sake of learning, Then from this point, if you go horizontally leftward, you can find the corresponding internal energy with a reference, with respect to some reference. The internal energy as per the thermodynamic properties can be positive, it can be negative. Because if the enthalpy value is zero as described in the assumptions, then H is equal to U plus PV, then there are corresponding properties getting involved, like temperature, pressure, specific volume. Because of those properties and with respect to the reference assigned zero value of enthalpy, you get positive values also and you get negative values also. So after locating this point with just two input values, you are able to go leftward and get the corresponding value of U, and you go downwards, you get the corresponding value of S. Then you will also get the corresponding value of temperature. If the data was only in terms of pressure and a specific volume, then a third property like temperature was not given, then we will see which is the line of temperature which could pass through this point. Sometimes the point could be here, point could be here. In this, something like a trapezium, a parallelogram type of a gap, that means you have to calibrate, you have to see approximately what could be the values. The line may not pass exactly through every point that could be located. If the point is located here, suppose here, apparently, none of the lines passes through this, then, we have to do interpolation. We have to do interpolation what could be the value of the pressure, volume and temperature. That means, you know, our study about this graph should be complete. Then again, in the numerical, it is given. After locating the point one during expansion process, the expansion is reversible and adiabatic. When the expansion is reversible and adiabatic, that means it goes downwards. Reversible adiabatic means isentropic. Isentropic means the value of entropy remains constant. You have the experience of basic thermodynamics. We always used to draw constant entropy lines vertically downwards. So reversible adiabatic or isentropic expansion process should be vertically downwards. Okay, if it is vertically downwards, then in the numerical it was given compression ratio was 8. So if it is, you know, if it is V2 by V1 is 8, that means V2 is equal to 8 times V1. And if V2 is 8 times V1, if V1 is given, that means corresponding V2 can be calculated and located here on this line which goes vertically downwards. One input now is the vertical line going downwards. Second input now is the value of V2, that is 8 times V1, corresponding to compression ratio as given in the numerical. Because if the compression ratio is defined as V2 by V1, which is equal to 8, that means V2 is equal to 8 times V1. V1 is given something like 0 point something. That means V2 can be calculated. We will see the corresponding lines of a specific volume, you know, with the units of per kg of air, you know, crossing through that point, either directly or by interpolation. And we are able to locate that point somewhere here, you know, somewhere here. And if that point is somewhere, the first point is here, the dot is here, the first point is somewhere here with a dot, the second point is vertically downwards somewhere here. Then once you are able to locate this second point here, then all the thermodynamic properties can be, you know, taken from the table itself. Properties, the value of properties like temperature, pressure, and specific volume, as well as entropy, constant entropy, as well as the internal energy on the left hand side. Okay, and the value of P1 was given 7100 kilopascals and V1 0.125 cubic meters, you know, per kg of air. Then the corresponding chart chosen was for the value of phi equal to 1.0. Then once we are able to locate the point one on the chart, then we get the other properties like T1, U1 and S1. Okay, then after, you know, we can draw this graph here and show the expansion process for our understanding. V2 by V1 is 8, that means V2 is equal to 8 times V1. After locating point one and getting remaining properties, remaining thermodynamic properties, then the gas expands at constant entropy to V2 is equal to 8 times V1. That means we are able to calculate this is equal to 1 cubic meter per kg of air. After multiplication, you should be able to get it. 8 into 0.125. Then, you know, following a constant entropy process from stage 1 going vertically downwards on figure 8, then locating the point number 2, we are able to get a T2, P2 and U2, you know, that means 1840 Kelvin, 570 kilopascal and U2 minus 1540 kilojoules per kg of air. Then expansion stroke work, if it is given the numerical, calculate the expansion stroke work. The expansion stroke work, assuming the process is adiabatic, you know, assuming the process adiabatic, that means then del Q is equal to 0. That means, you know, del Q is equal to del W plus du, something like that. Once you do the cancellations in terms of del Q, that means you have W12. The work done during expansion process is, you know, U2 minus U1, negative of that as per the first law of thermodynamics for a process. You choose the first law of thermodynamics for a process, then you see del Q is equal to 0. Then substitute the values of U2 and U1. You get a corresponding value of work done during expansion as 1535 kilojoules per kg of air. This work is a positive by means of calculations because the work done during expansion process by any engine is a positive as per the thermodynamic conventions. You know, the work done by the system is positive. The work done on the system is negative. So the remaining paragraph, you know, the remaining paragraph you can leave, you know, because we don't want to make the syllabus and contents too much lengthy, you know. Once we know the basics, you know, once we know the basics and we are with the syllabus also, then we can, there is always you know, a possibility of getting more knowledge in future classes, in future at higher level, maybe M.Tech level or doctorate level. Not only at doctorate level, but at the postdoctorate level as well. Then when you come to different organizations and with different jobs, maybe research investigations and any job, you know, any job will give you further knowledge, you know. You will always get more knowledge, whatever job, you know, will come to your luck. If you have any questions, you know, you can ask. So what we have done the thermodynamic charts for IC engine, that is for the mixtures. Mixture before combustion means corresponding to processes like combustion process. Then mixture after combustion, that means for processes like expansion process. Okay, and you know, with the corresponding thermodynamic properties, basically their values, you know, their values, which can be very close to the actual values, and they help us to understand the, you know, working of engines, you know, working of engines, what happens in the engines in terms of the you know, energy and in terms of the values of thermodynamic properties, because work is also an energy, you know. Negative work means work is done on the system, and positive work is, means that work is done by the system. In addition to this, you know, work done on the system and work done by the system, as per the charts, you know, we are able to see what happens to various thermodynamic properties, you know, with respect to their numerical values. But of course, you know, they are basically with respect to that datum, you know, where the reference enthalpy is zero, you know, so that has to be taken into consideration. If you have any questions, otherwise we will stop here today. And as per your, you know, as per your suggestion, we are meeting after the exam, perhaps, is it?
Yes, sir.
So I will be sending this lecture to you along with the chart by email. So we will be meeting for the next class after your exam, that's midterm exam, finishes. You know, after your exam is over, then we will meet for the class, Google Meet class again. And then, you know, remaining lectures are, you know, kept pending for the time.
Okay, sir.
So should we stop here today?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.